Welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I just wanted to come quickly and just talk to you a little bit about making choices. I get emails every single day almost with the call sign, help me, Chelsea, help me. I need help. These fibroids, I need help. This bleeding, I need help. I have anemia, I need help. And so I want to just say, first off, There are so many resources in the videos that I have on YouTube. So if you haven't taken the time to watch those videos, I know it can be labor intensive, sometimes boring, whatever. But if you want help, that's the first place to start. One is free. One is good information. And one, there's healing to be had by following the advice that I give you on those videos, you know? So my suggestion is that you take the information that is free and run with it and like really, you know, engross yourself into learning what it is that I'm teaching you, because what I'm teaching you, it really will help you. So the second part of this is the thing that I want to say here today is you have choices to make. And they're your choices. It doesn't matter what the choice is, but they are your choices. And you get to decide whether or not your choices are going to be good for you or if they're going to be not so good for you. So for example, you get to this, it is a choice if you decide not to exercise just as much as it is a choice if you decide to exercise. It is a choice whether or not you choose to eat healthy food, and it is a choice if you choose to eat unhealthy food. Either way, it's a choice and it is your choice, and that choice is going to lead to either blessings or curses. Unfortunately, I don't mean to use the word curses. I don't want to say that I'm putting a curse on you or that you're putting a curse on yourself. But the way the Bible says, it says today, choose this day, life or death, blessings or curses. So if you choose to take care of yourself, you'll get the fruit of taking care of yourself, health, strength, energy, positivity. But you can also choose death, which is, you know, not taking care of yourself, not exercising, not eating well, not doing the things that you know you need to do to take good care of yourself. All of it is a choice. Now, sometimes our choices are like, we can't make the choice. We feel like we can't make the choice. We're so bogged down in how bad we feel mentally, emotionally, spiritually, we're just in a rut and we just feel like we can't make any good choices, that we're stuck in our terrible choices, you know? And we don't have to stay in that vein. We can actually make good choices. So if you find that you feel stuck, it means it's time for you to turn to God and ask for some help. And some of you listening to me, you're believers. A lot of you are believers because a lot of you have told me you're believers, and some of believers in Jesus Christ, I should say. And some of you have said that you're not. And that's fine. It doesn't matter to me. I mean, it matters, but it like you get to choose what your path is going to be. And if you choose to follow Christ, great. If you choose to follow another path, that's good too, because it's the thing that you feel like is the best for you. Okay. So, but all I'm saying in that is if you feel like you are stuck and you are in bondage, I am telling you that the way out of it is to turn to God. And when you are in a battle like that, it's time for you to hit your knees and start talking to the one that can get you out of the problem that you're in. So if you find that you can't make good choices, you want to make good choices and you can't make good choices, ask him to help you. And God always says, keep on knocking, keep on asking, keep on knocking, keep on asking, keep on knocking, asking, you know, like knock on the door until you get the answer that you're looking for. But I think what happens is a lot of times we want God to change things in our lives and we want the results of, you know, having health and strength and all that stuff, but we don't want to do what it takes to get there. And that's what we have to evaluate, because God is there to help us. We sometimes just don't want to do the thing that's hard. And that's a choice too. That's why I'm saying everything is a choice. If we are in a rut where we feel like we can't get out, we feel trapped and in bondage, well, your choice, a good choice that will get you out of it, is to turn to God. Turn to God and ask Him to help you get out and follow through with it. Don't just ask one time. Keep on asking until you get out of it. And don't like sit there for 5 minutes and just say, oh, well, He didn't help me. Ask until you get what you need. And if you have, if you need help with this, put a comment below in the description box of this video and ask for help. Show up whenever I'm doing the prayer sessions. On Sunday, I will be doing a prayer session at 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I think that's June 5th on Sunday, Eastern Standard Time. And I'll be happy to pray for you during that time. But just ask for help. There's help for you. And also, if you need to know something about how to help your body to heal naturally from fibroids, start going through these videos on this YouTube channel. Like, there's a ton of stuff. If you don't have time to do that, you can set up an appointment with me to do a discovery call to see if my 90-day Walk the Fibroid Freedom group coaching program is the right thing for you. And if it is, then maybe we can, you know, have you be a part of the group. The next group starts on July 11th. And you can set an appointment with me, set an appointment sooner rather than later, because I get booked up really quickly because I only coach on certain days for the discovery calls. So if you want to talk to me, get on my calendar and let's talk. Let's see if it's a right fit for you. And if you don't, if you're not interested in doing the 90-day program, schedule a 50-minute session with me so that I can, you know, find out what's going on with you and write a protocol for you so that you can get on the right path to healing. I will put links to both of those down in the description box of this video. But I just came impromptu today just to tell you that everything is a choice and you can get out of this situation that you're in. You do not have to be bleeding your guts out every month. You do not have to be, you know, looking 8 months pregnant every day. You don't have to do that. It's a choice. It's a choice. You can choose to get out of this situation or you can choose to stay in it. What is it going to be? You are able to do anything that you set your mind to. And God is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that you could ask or think. Some of you want babies. You can have a baby. There's testimonies about women who have had fibroids and the doctor was telling them to remove their womb. And they had the baby, a healthy baby, healthy pregnancy. That's possible. There's people who have lost their hair and who have a head full of hair now because they got their body in a position where the body healed so their hair would grow back. So let me just tell you, I'm going to stop now, stop talking, but I just wanted to encourage you. Whether we talk ever again, I just want to say you can make a choice to get well. You can. There, right here on this channel is information at your fingertips that can help you on your way to health. All right, ladies, lots of love to you. I'll talk to you later. Take care.